And the silver and thy gold is multiplied, and all that thou hast is multiplied. Then thine heart be lifted up, and thou forget the Lord thy God. You know, before you knew the Lord, if you think about yourself in the past, what did you have? Next to nothing. Maybe you had some money, but no joy, no happiness, no health. And maybe you had you had a wife, you have children, but there was no happiness in that family completely. But now you came to know the Lord, and the Lord has turned everything around, and the Lord is saying, beware. Lest after you've gotten this and this and that, now you forget the Lord. Look at, you know, the church that you belong to. This church, God has raised us up, and is still raising us up in Jesus' name. And for you to have a foothold here, and for you to have position here, what a great privilege. But then after getting the position and the privilege, beware that that position will not make you to forget God. You will not forget God. So he's saying to us in that verse 14, let thine heart be lifted up, and thou forget the Lord thy God, which brought thee forth out of the land of Egypt, from the house of bondage, who led thee through the great and terrible wilderness, wherein were fiery serpents and scorpions and drought, where there was no water, who brought thee forth water out of the rock of flint, who fed thee in the wilderness with manna, which thy fathers knew not, that he might humble thee, and that he might prove thee to do thee good at thy latter end. And thou shalt say in thine heart, my power and my might and the might of my hand has gotten me this wealth. But thou shalt remember the Lord thy God, for it is he that giveth thee power to get wealth. Who has given you prosperity? Who gave you health? Who gave you your wife? Who gave you that good husband? Who gave you children? Who has blessed your life? That's what you remember every time. Thou shalt remember the Lord thy God, for it is he that giveth thee power to get wealth, that he may establish his covenant, which he sware unto thy fathers, as it is this day. And it shall be, if thou at all forget the Lord thy God, if thou at all forget the Lord thy God, will you forget him?
No.
You will not. If thou do at all forget the Lord thy God, and walk after the gods, after other gods, and serve them, and worship them, I testify against thee this day that he shall surely perish. Forgetting God would lead to destruction, would lead to damnation, would lead to desolation. In verse 20, as the nations which the Lord destroyeth before your face, so shall ye perish, because ye would not be obedient unto the voice of the Lord thy God. We will not forget God. Psalm 50, I'm reading there from verse 16. Psalm 50, and we're reading from verse 16. Psalm 50, verse 16. But unto the wicked God saith, what hast thou to do to declare my statutes, or that thou shouldest take my covenant in thy mouth, seeing thou hatest instruction and castest my words behind thee? Those are the signs of forgetting God. When somebody has not come, he has position, somebody has prosperity, somebody has a good family, somebody has built houses, somebody has established this company, that company, somebody has done this, has done that, and then people are looking up to him like a benefactor, and now he's got this and got that. People are saying, yes sir, yes sir, yes madam, yes ma'am. And then he forgets that it is God that has raised him up to come to that level. When somebody comes to a church like this, you came like a newcomer, and then eventually you became born again, new convert, then you became a real disciple, then you became a worker, and then you are now one of the leaders. And people are saying, yes sir, yes sir, yes my brother, what do you want me to do? And then you have all these people there, you know, listening to you, and then you become proud. And you forget, there was a time you came in just like a sinner, and you had nothing in the kingdom. But now, God has given you all this honor, all this exaltation, and he still wants to do more for you. But before that one comes, you're so proud now. and then you forget God, I pray it will not happen to you. Listen, verse 7, to see thou hatest instruction and casteth my words behind thee. You know, after we get to some position, we hate instruction, we hate study, we hate learning, we hate correction, then we forget where we're coming from. And then it says in verse 18, when thou sowest a seed, and then thou consentest thou with him. And then it says, and has been partaker with adulterers. He said, now we so forget God that if somebody is committing adultery and they report him in the district or in the church or anywhere, we then become partakers, so they will come their friends. We say, don't mind them. Who is clean? Who is holy? They're saying that you committed adultery, you committed fornication. How about them? Who knows what they're doing in secret? They're a partaker of evildoers, of fornicators, and they become your friends, and they are the people that are very familiar with you. Since you are forgetting God, you don't hate what God hates. You delight in evil. It says you become partakers with evil doers, with thieves and with fornicators, with adulterers, and thou givest thy mouth to evil, and thy tongue frameth deceit. Thou sittest and speakest against thy brother. Thou slanderest thine own mother's son. You know, if the Lord condemned the people that slander even their own relatives, their mother's son, how about the people that slander our leaders, our coordinators, our group coordinators? How about the people that are so audacious and so backsliding, they can even slander their pastor? And the Lord is saying, are you forgetting God? That's the pastor that helped you to understand salvation and sanctification, and the life that qualifies us for heaven. And then you can sit behind privately somewhere and slander such a man who's helping you to know the Lord more. It says you are forgetting something important. Beware lest a terrible thing comes upon your life. It said in verse 21, these things thou hast done, and I kept silence. And thou thoughtest that I was altogether such an one as thyself. But I will reprove thee and set them in order before thine eyes. Now consider this, ye that forget God, lest I tear you in pieces and there be none to deliver. I pray you'll not forget God. You know, in the final end, what happens to the people that forget God? We're looking at Psalm 9 verse 17. Psalm 9, I'm looking at verse 17. It says, the wicked shall be turned into hell, and all the nations that forget God. That's the danger. The wicked shall be turned into hell, and all the nations that forget God. I will not forget God. You will not forget God. And this church, as a whole, our leaders and all the members, we will not forget God in Jesus' name. Psalm 119 verse 16, Psalm 119 verse 16, Psalm 119 verse 16. I will delight myself in thy statutes. I will not forget thy word. I will not forget thy word. Verse 61. In verse 61, the bands of the wicked have robbed me, but I have not forgotten thy law. Persecution may be there, problems may be there. There's one thing that you must never do. Never forget the word of the Lord. In this same psalm, I'm looking at verse 83. For I am become like a bottle in the smoke. That means all these people, they are around me like the smoke of the fire. And they want to irritate my life until they snuff the breath out of me. It says, and become like a bottle in the smoke. Yet do I not forget thy statutes. It said, whatever is happening and whatever may happen, I will never forget. Look at verse 93. I will never forget thy precepts. For with them thou hast quickened me, you brought me back to life. It says, because of that, I will never forget. Can I hear you say that? You'll never forget the word of the Lord in Jesus' name. Look at verse 109. My soul is continually in my hand, yet do I not forget thy law. Yet do I not forget. Never. Whatever is happening around you, sometimes sickness will come, Remember the promises of God. Never forget the Lord. Sometimes it's persecution. Sometimes it's slander. The people try to slander your life. Don't say, okay, if that is so, then let me forget about it. And where was everything? I don't want to be a Christian again. That will never happen to you. You always remain a child of God. Whatever the people do, whatever the people say, you will never forget. 139, that is verse 139, my zeal has consumed me because my enemies have forgotten thy word. When my enemies forget the word of the Lord, I become more zealous. When nobody is preaching holiness, I become more zealous for holiness. When nobody is doing evangelism, I become more zealous for evangelism. And when nobody is praying, I become more zealous for prayer. When my enemies are trying to pull the honor and the glory of God, now I become more zealous in lifting up that glory of the Lord. In verse 139, my zeal has consumed me because my enemies have forgotten thy words. 141, I am small and despised. They belittle me, they cut me down, and they make me so small, and they say, oh, who is that, so and so? And then they look down upon you. He said in verse 141, I am small and despised, yet do I not forget thy precept. He said, I have one thing going for me, and it is that I will never forget the Lord, I'll never forget his word, because I know the judgment that will come upon those that forget. Verse 153, it says, consider my affliction and deliver me, for I do not forget thy law. I do not forget, I will not forget, I must not forget. I will always remember the Lord in Jesus' name. The Lord is telling us today that he's done so much for us. And there's one thing for us to do so that we can keep the blessing and multiply the blessing. And those better things will come in our lives. We will not forget the Lord in Jesus' name. Let me remind you again of Ezekiel chapter 36. Ezekiel chapter 36, and I'm reading from verse 11. Ezekiel 36, verse 11, and I will multiply upon you man and beast, and they shall increase and bring forth, and I will settle you after your old estates, and will do better unto you than at your beginnings. God says he'll do better unto us than at the beginning, and ye shall know that I am the Lord. What are we to do so that that will come to pass? You love the Lord with all your heart, all your soul, and all your mind, and something better is in front of you already. Just one step forward, you are there already. Rise up and tell the Lord, I believe, I believe, I believe. Better things are coming, greater things are coming, higher things are coming, beautiful things are coming, and they're coming upon your life. Lord, I believe, Lord, I believe, Lord, I believe. Good things are coming, better things are coming. And what the Lord is saying is that you remember the Lord, remember the Lord, remember the Lord, remember the Lord. Don't forget, don't forget, don't forget, don't forget. Don't forget his word. Give yourself to him completely, entirely. Is there any sin in your life? Any backsliding? Any evil? Repent and say, Lord, I am sorry. Any disobedience? Lord, I am sorry. Waywardness? Lord, I am sorry. Secret sin, private sin, slandering our leaders, give me your mouth to evil. Lord, I'm sorry. Tell the Lord you're sorry, and the Lord will forgive. Then you pledge your life, consecrate your life, submit your life, surrender your life unto continual obedience, day to day obedience, regular obedience. Continual obedience unto the Lord. That's what brings the blessing. That's what brings the blessing. Destroy those bad habits, those sinful traits. Get rid of them. Come back to the Lord. There's restoration for the backslider. Lord, I am sorry. I know Jesus died for me on the cross of Calvary. He gave his blood. on his blood. Give his life, all his life. Give himself, all of himself. He gave for your salvation. Come believing, come believing. Come to Jesus, look and live. He died for you to take your sins away. Believe on the Lord Jesus Christ, and thou shalt be saved. He shed his blood for you. He's done everything for your salvation. Now promise him that you will not be among the people that forget. Forgetting the Lord. Forgetting his word. Forgetting his commandments. Forgetting the goodness of the Lord. Pray that God will help you. You'll not be among those who forget God. After God has blessed them, after God has healed them, after God has given them the blessings of life, husband, wife, children, job, certificate, position, privilege, pray that you'll not be among the people that forget the goodness of the Lord. Every day you remember, see what God has done. Every day you glorify him, see what the Lord has done. And because you remember what the Lord has done, you'll say, I surrender my life afresh every day, consecrating every moment to the Lord. Heart, life, will, mind, strength, all laid at the altar of the Lord. Lord, I offer everything I've got unto you. Take me, Lord. Even now, even me. Take all I've got and use it for your glory.